Welcome to Africa in Vogue, where we introduce you to the latest up-and-coming faces in art, fashion, and music.
What's up, plus all this hypocrisy?
We have amazing, amazing, amazing talent coming out for you.
What be this, what be that, what be this? Take away one of people, trick them, go treat them, I see them, let them.
We're on our way to meet Serge Attukwei, an amazing artist I'm sure you would have heard of or seen around. He is the guy behind Afrogallonism.
All the gallons he's been seeing, the yellow gallons that he's been wasted. Gallons. He's wasted so many of them, and we're going to see him and we're going to ask him to account. He's going to have to account to us why he's using our yellow gallons, our kupo, precious kupo gallons to make art. We don't understand.
Your shoes are sinking into the ground.
Yes, it's sinking sand.
Serious,
Charlie.
So we'll find out more from him. We're so excited to find out. He's, you know, he's a quiet, shy type, but I think we're going to get him out of his shell. You know.
I mean, if you see two girls like this, once you talk, anything you have in your head, you will pull it out. Pull it out of you.
Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the show. I know I always say that every week, but you will enjoy the show.
Yeah. I mean, if you have people like Hezuma on your TV, why wouldn't you enjoy it?
Enjoy the soul. Alright, bye guys.
Bye.
Tell me what you want me to know. High grade mafia, high level thievery, wrongful imprisonment.
Serge Attukwei is a Ghanaian professional artist and illustrator, born and raised in La, Ghana. He is the founder of Ghana's Go Lokal Performance Collective. His work combines activism and art, usually commenting and raising awareness on society's cultural, political, and personal ignorance and failures. Topics tackled in Serge's performances and works include pollution, global conflicts, capitalism, and racism. His recent project, Afrogallonism, is an experiment with the yellow gallon containers found throughout Ghana, known as Kufuor gallons, after John Kufuor, the former president of Ghana. Serge is well-traveled. He's been to the US, UK, Brazil, Austria, amongst others, exhibiting his work, participating in workshops and promoting his works. Serge is not only an artist, but a teacher, model and photographer, a man of many talents.
Welcome to Attukwei Studio in Labadi.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
It's nice to meet you. I feel like I'm in your castle, like you're the king.
Kind of. Castle. Yeah.
More like we're invading your space.
Yeah, you're welcome anyways.
Thank
yeah.
you. So tell us, who is Attukwei?
Who is Attukwei? It's kind of a question that I always find it difficult to answer because Attukwei is an ordinary artist born and raised in Labadi who is very critical about his topics.
What inspires Attukwei?
Well, what inspires Attukwei? Actually, my family is migrated from Jamestown to Labadi. So we have this kind of migration background. So we are here, but we are not from Labadi. So that has been like sort of my inspiration, referencing my work, like using those historical narrative in my process.
I feel like we went into a different zone there, but nice.
We are not New York,
so we are surrounded by all of these pieces of art.
Right.
Talk us through it. What is this? What are we seeing?
Okay, what you see right now, you mostly see like yellow, which is very dominant mm-hmm. in my process because I've been working with this plastic gallon for like 15 years ago, but it started as just an object that I paint on them as an artist because my dad is an artist and I grew up with my dad. But my dad does like traditional paintings and, you know, so I grew up with him, so I began to work like him. But in 2006, I had a sponsorship to study art in Brazil, which gives me a new approach to my work. So after 2006, I came back to Ghana and began to realize how strongly I can use my ideas or materials as a very strong point of connection in relationship with the traditional aspect of. So I began to work with found objects. And I thought of, because I was young by then, I thought of like working with materials that I can easily afford, that I can still be the artist that I want, you know. But before I was interested in electronics and my dad was like, yeah, you are black, you are African, you can't invent. So you have to like paint so that you make money. So I begin to work with this plastic gallon, like use them as a canvas piece, put them together, have a big mirror and just work on it. And I went on and I realized that I've consumed so much that I don't even have space to store them. So the next step was to find a way to to reduce the volume itself, like through the cutting process. Mm. I mean, this is like very symbolic material in my work, and I find ways to explore in different forms by using them as kind of functional objects. Yeah.
So these yellow gallons are known as Kufuor gallons.
Yeah.
And you have the Afrogallonism
right.
Movement or project.
Right.
Can you tell us what Afrogallonism is
yeah,
about?
Yeah, the Afrogallonism started, the name came out in 3 years ago because I was working with this for a long time and people kind of like don't really get it because they thought I was just breaking these gallons and just destroying them, you know, but it originally comes from like Europe, Turkey or Malaysia or somewhere that we consume. So they come in as oil containers, but we use them after the oil as water storage. So I thought of, okay, let me just start this movement whereby people begin to realize, because when you go to different homes, you see people use them as chairs, you know, but they are not really aware of it, how possible they can even transform into very comfortable chairs. So Afrogallonism is a movement to explore with this plastic. It's also like a futuristic idea. If Africa has water in the future, what are those gallons be used for?
Exactly.
So my perspective was to find where and stand firm as an artist to send this material back to where they come from.
Okay.
Because when the plastic gallon itself goes to Europe or where it comes from, they can't use it, you know, but once it goes through my artistic process, like cutting and making a huge installation, with text like keep off, you know, those things that it means differently in their space. So it's about migration of objects from one end to another because it transforms its value, its functions over the space in which it goes through.
That's very interesting.
When you were talking in the last question, you said that sometimes the way people don't understand when you are collecting scraps and stuff, what has been like your biggest challenge with the mentality of the Ghanaian people?
Well, it has been a very big challenge because based on the material that I work with, I really want to interact with people for them to understand the material in my process. So moving here was a bit difficult because, I mean, people use this plastic like to survive every single day. The water doesn't flow here like except the weekends, and people are very aggressive every Saturday because they have to, you know, collect water and store for the rest of the week. You know, and you see that I keep cutting it. And even my process is very labor intense, you know, like we have to go to the dump site to carry them on our back. I'm interested in like the process which creates a dialogue because people see me, I carry them at my back from the ocean all the way to the house and they see us like all the time. We want to do that too, for people to kind of question where we are taking these materials to. And people does, you know, and even we have to go there, buy, they have to weigh them. I pay and carry it. So, I mean, the process is actually what is very challenging, but also it also give a kind of dialogue, especially this community that it's a poor community actually, but when you see, you know, so I use my work as a point of contact, like our space, how we can develop the community through the art, you know, so I kind of like engage people in my process.
So you've told us what the Ghanaian people think about art in general. How do the West perceive your artwork when you actually travel abroad? Because you've done a lot of exhibitions in the US and the UK. How do they perceive your art?
Well, before I get to travel to Europe, what I do was, after I completed school from Brazil, I came back and I begin to work because my dad said I can't live with this. I can't make money out of this. So what I do was photograph and share my work online, like, so I keep posting images of my work, and I get feedback from different parts of the world, like magazines want to interview me about work, you know, I get publications, and so I felt like, okay, I mean, they understand, but I need to let the people around me to understand more, you know, so what I do is I kind of like take my work in public space, just hang them, just put them, the people just work on it, see it, and talk about it, you know, so yeah, but the West is something that has inspired me a lot, thinking outside of Africa, like how they perceive African art. You know, what they see is African art is like, you know, you see women carrying baskets in a market. And for me, that is how they see African art. Just a wooden sculpture of someone, like a trophy and all that. So when I go there, I'm interested in how can I use my experience living in Africa or raised in Africa to explore that space. Mm. So I'm interested in working with materials that we import from America or Europe, okay, and how we transform them back to where it comes from. Mm-hmm. So I then use performance as the process. Mm-hmm. So the outcome of my whatever I work with become the work. Mm-hmm. So I'm interested in like talking about environmental issues, racism, migration, you know, those are the elements that can hit them hard,
yeah,
when you,
yeah,
go to the, definitely, you know, Europe, and because they know African art has to be with like just women carrying water, mm-hmm, women semi-nude and, you know, mm-hmm, carry baby, mm-hmm, and for me it's beyond that, mm-hmm, you know, we are in contemporary world that we engage globalization is happening, so you know we have to find ways to position ourselves, okay, as an Africans in their space, mm-hmm, and how they perceive. So I'm interested in also working with the African diaspora, which is the main sort of my, okay, interest.
Obviously you can't do all this by yourself,
right.
Obviously you have to have people around, yeah, you. I've heard that you started a collective, they're called the Go Lokal Collective.
Go Lokal.
Do talk to us a little bit about that.
The Go Lokal started in 2012, mm-hmm, when I moved here a year ago, and I'm interested in, you know, I think that art is something that has to be shared, mm, especially around your space before you can extend into like any space. So when I started this, I have these people around who want to engage, but they don't know how to get into this whole. So I decided to invite them into my studio. I went through, I did a presentation about my work, like, okay, previous. I used to do like solo performances, but, mm-hmm, I began to realize that people want to engage. Mm-hmm. I think that it's, they have idea, but they don't have like the platform. So, mm-hmm, because I have it, I just engage them. So the first performance was about the election 2012. Mm-hmm. What we did was we went on the streets, peeled off all those political posters, and I made a costume which represent the youth. Okay. They're trying to criticize the youth and the politicians. Mm-hmm. So the idea was to create that huge awareness. Mm-hmm. So I represent the youth, and my guys dressed in like very, very political, in suit and a tie, well dressed with briefcase on the street. So we went on the street, and I have like strings tied to my neck, my hands, so they had to drag me. That was 4 days before election, and there was a huge tension. Everybody was scared if this would be a conflict and all that.
Of course.
So we went on the street without any notice, and we started the whole process. Have the costume, and they have to drag me, stop the cars, and they drag me to the on the pavement. They have to drag me with money and all that. Okay. And funny enough, we have this news crew from Vassat who were there to cover the whole performance. Mm-hmm. So like it created a huge tension, and everybody was coming out from their cars to photograph. And people thought I was paid for, you know, and people thought I was also campaigning for a sitting president,
yeah,
which I'm not. Mm-hmm. So after the performance, we went back home. The video was on news that night, like the whole week.
Okay.
And I received like calls and emails that they thought I was arrested or something.
Okay.
So I felt like there is something huge with this performance, you know, and also engaging the locals, because they have sort of like critical ideas that they want to work around. But because they are not artists, they lack that kind of confidence. Mm. So for me, it's to engage them, to collaborate, to become a team so that we can push forward and also develop our community based on those artistic ideas. So it went really well, and after that we have a couple of performances which has been very great.
It's been great. And
interesting. It's been very wonderful talking to you, by the way. It's been very enlightening, because I see it all the time, but I didn't really understand where it was coming from.
Definitely.
So thank you so much for inviting us.
Thank you so much for allowing us to come in here.
Yeah, you're
welcome. And invade your space.
Very grateful to have you here.
Yeah. Thank you.
I think that it's very interesting for me how like Africans realize their creative industry, people around, and how to engage them in their practice. So I'm interested in how I can invite people here, especially Africans, to just, you know my work and share it.
Exactly. And to get to know the arts more.
I get to know the real you, the man behind the arts.
Yeah. I'm known with my work, but not personally.
It's
been nice talking to Attukwei.
Thank you so much.
Bishop Namiliki, Fopu na enjoyment, Imamu na gbaladun. Ra 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 ra.
waiting, you go here. My sister waiting, you go here.